हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे टॉपिक इज जेट बफर एल्गोरिथम और यू कैन से डेप्थ बफर एल्गोरिथम। इन दिस एल्गोरिथम इट विल बी यूज फॉर पैक फेस एलिमिनेशन मेथड। एज यू नो ऑलरेडी इन माय लास्ट वीडियो आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट सम लिमिटेशंस ऑफ द पैक फेस एल्गोरिथम। सो इन दैट लिमिटेशन ओवरकम दिस एल्गोरिथम विल बी यूजफुल। इन दैट एल्गोरिथम आई टोल्ड यू दैट दैट एल्गोरिथम इज नॉट यूजफुल फॉर द overlapping objects. So for that overlapping objects, that this algorithm, jet buffer algorithm, will be useful. It will be mainly used for the jet buffer algorithm. So let's see in this example. You can see here the x-axis, y-axis and z positive axis and z negative axis. Here one point will be available, that will be x comma y. That pixel have some overlap surfaces are there, just like S1, S2 and S3, and every pixel have some intensity value in each surface. Okay, so here we'll discuss about these things in the later, but here I am telling you about the jet buffer algorithm. Okay, so after that we will discuss about the surfaces and that intensity values. So here that will be used for the jet buffer algorithm, that will be used for the overlapping surfaces. Okay, so that algorithm is use image space method for the eliminating back face surfaces or hidden surfaces. Okay, and this algorithm is compare surface depth at each pixel position. Depth means every pixel whatever overlapping with surface to surface, means that if one image is there, sorry, one object is there, and after the object some overlapping surfaces are there, so we have to check each pixel intensity in every surface. Okay, so that every surface, whenever you want to calculate, this is called the depth of each pixel position. Just like here, x, y, one pixel will be there, and that pixel have three surfaces, S1 and S2, S3. When we will calculate about the intensity value of S1, S2, S3, every surface in each pixel, that is called the depth of each pixel position. Okay, so here, how we can calculate it, how we can check it, now we will discuss about this. First, we will check depth of the pixel x, y, and depth is called the z value. And z value will be here for surface S1, S2, S3. Different surfaces have a different z value. I hope you already knows about the depth. I already told you in my last video, so please go through in that video so you can understand what is the depth. Okay, so here for this purpose we have two buffers where our values will be stored. First one is z buffer and second one is refresh buffer. In the z buffer, the z value will be stored, and every z value have pixels intensity, and that intensity will be stored on the refresh buffer. Okay, so these two buffers will be used for the storing the values. Okay, now how these values are stored in these two buffers, it will be depend on again two cases. First case will be here, if that cases are depend on the sitting of your viewport and where viewport will be seen or looking. Okay, so for an example, in this diagram you can see if you are in sitting in the z axis. Okay, so here you can see in the first case, I think now it will be visible properly. If you are sitting in positive z axis and looking at the origin, or you can say negative z axis. Okay, so that time what you have to do, the first case is this, and second case is if you are sitting in negative z axis and looking at the origin, or you can say looking at the positive z axis, that time suppose that these S1, S2, S3 surfaces have some values. Okay, z values are there. So we suppose that the z values are here. Z values are S1, Z S1 in the surface 1, Z1 value, minus 4, S2 z value will be minus 6, and S3 surface 3 z value will be minus 8. So how you can check it, which one is closer, which one is farther for each cases? So if you are talking about the first case, here larger z value will be closer from where your viewport will be sitting. Second, smaller, which one is smaller, that will be farther. For example, in this case, example, S1 is Z is equal to minus 4, Z is equal to S2, Z is equal to minus 6, S3, Z is equal to minus 8. So here, closer will be larger value. Which one is larger? Z minus 4 and smaller minus 8. So like this, we have to check it. And next, if you want to see in the case 2, in this case, just opposite will be here. Which one is smaller Z value, that will be closer, and larger one will be farther. Okay, how you can calculate these values, now we will come in this topic. Okay, so here how you can calculate it, first you have to check it depth buffer dxy is equal to 0. In that time you have to suppose refresh buffer rxy will be I, which is called the background color. For example, that I told you that every pixel have some Z value and their intensity. And what is intensity? Intensity is background color value. Okay, so here I value is intensity, and that will be called the background color value. And here, if Z new means next surface of that pixel. Okay, so depth new value will be is less greater than dxy. If then dxy depth value will be change or update with Z new value. Z new value, as I told you, in the new surface, as for example S1, okay, S1 is a new surface. Okay, so in that new surface, what is the next new depth value? If that depth value will be greater than old depth value, then it will be update with the Z new value, and intensity value will be also update with the Z surface intensity value. Okay, the same thing will be here also, but just little bit different in the case 2. If Z new value, new surface Z value is less than dxy, okay, then it will be also updated, and dxy will be updated with the Z new, and rxy intensity value will be also updated. Like this we have to do it. Okay, next, this algorithm is completed from here, but you have to know also how to use for decreasing the calculation. Okay, so how you can use it? This will be used with the help of surface equation. As I told you before, what is the surface equation? Are ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to 0. This is the surface equation. So here, for example, here we have one polygon. Okay, and that polygon have three scan lines. Second scan line value will be y, and next one is y minus 1, because it will be coming on the downward. Okay, and here in this, first intersecting point in the polygon is x, and second intersecting point will be x plus 1. So each x have same y value, right? So according to that, we have to see here what is the next z value will be here. First, you have to solve this equation, and you can get z value will be is equal to minus ax minus by minus t divided by c. So if you want to calculate the x plus 1 value, then the same thing you have to do, in the x will be replaced with the x plus 1. So here z dash is equal to new z value. Okay, so z dash is equal to minus a x plus 1 minus by minus t divided by c. So after solving this equation, what is coming? Z minus a divided by c, and a divided by c is also the constant. So now you can understand, if we have to use calculation, then it will be so much easy calculation part, because if you want to get new surface value, just you have to update with the constant value with old Z value. That's it. Okay, so like this you can decrease the calculation part for getting information and removing, eliminating the back face surfaces. Okay, so now one more thing is coming, which is called the drawbacks. What are the limitations of this algorithm? The limitations of this algorithm is, this algorithm is used for only opaque surfaces. Opaque surfaces means that which surface are not transparent. You cannot see one side to another side. Those surfaces are called the opaque surfaces. So this algorithm is only for the opaque surfaces. Okay, and for this removal we have to use a buffer algorithm, or you can say a buffer algorithm is anti-aliasing buffer algorithm, or you can say area average accumulation algorithm, which we will discuss in the next video. Thank you. I hope now you can get all the things about Z buffer algorithm, or you can say depth buffer algorithm. Thank you.